economy. I'm your host, Parker Shireman, and I am a freshman here at Loras College. I study finance, and I am gathered here with today
Amelia Lake. I'm also a freshman here at Loras, and I'm studying kinesiology.
My name is Colin Woods. I'm a sophomore here at Loras College, and I'm also studying kinesiology.
Manuel Hernandez, and I'm a senior here at Loras College, and I'm currently in majoring in biology.
So today we're here to discuss a little project that we have with our class. We had to interview someone that was 20 or 40 years older than us, and just get their perspective on what they thought of media and just the difference in generational media between our generation and their generation. And they kind of just helped us out, get us a little bit better perspective. So that leads to my first question is, who did you guys interview? What is their name and just relation to them?
I interviewed Chris Lake. He's 50 years old and he's my father. And I thought he'd have a unique perspective on this topic because he used to work in broadcasting.
Yeah, I interviewed Karen Jansen. She's my aunt. She's 48, and I chose her because she's an avid Facebook user.
I interviewed Sandra Cervellon. She's 39 years old. She's my aunt from my mother's side, and I interviewed her because of her unique economic background situation.
So I interviewed my great-uncle Dave, who was in the military for 30-plus years. The reason I interviewed him is because I thought that he would just give us a better perspective on the media overseas, because I know overseas and obviously in a different generation, just a little bit different, a little bit harder. They didn't have much to use over there. And that brings my next question is, what was media like when your interviewer was a kid, and what media sources did they use when they were younger?
For my dad, he mentioned that he didn't have a lot of access to media when he was younger. It was really only radio and newspapers, but he did mention that when he was growing up, it was like the very beginning of cable television.
Yeah, similar for Karen. Her and her family really only had television, whether it was news or cartoons. But she did mention that kind of the bulky computers were starting to come in, but they were only in like libraries, schools, and maybe in the homes of those that could afford them.
My aunt, likewise, like you guys, also grew up in like a poor economic situation background, where she and her eight sibling grew up with only like a small 8-square box TV, and can only access the media when entering high school.
Right. Basically same thing with me and Dave. He grew up in a family of 12, so it was always hard of who got the TV at what time, and that also didn't help because back in the generation, there was only a limited certain amount of channels. So you only got to watch like 3 or 4 channels at a time. But he also told me to get his main things, sources of media was every time he walked on the way to school, he would stop at the local gas station because they always had a newspaper. You give the clerk a dime and you can just get a newspaper which had all of his sports scores and just local media that he was interested in for that week. Next question was, what was the biggest difference between your interviewee in how they wrote letters back then to now where you can call, text, or email anytime?
He mentioned it was just a lot harder to keep in touch with friends from when he was younger. Once he got to college, he really only was able to keep in touch through like long distance phone calls and like calling cards, he said. So right now, he said it's a lot easier to be able to access people through text messages.
Yeah, for Karen, when she was younger, she loved to write. So letters and postcards were kind of her big thing, way to communicate with friends and family. Versus now, she kind of feels that call, text, email, it kind of takes away our ability to get creative with the way we communicate. But she does say the upside to it is the immediate, retrieval and being able to send text, message, email, and right away.
For my aunt, she didn't even bother writing letters as it took up too much time. And again, it costs money to use letters, which is why she's very grateful for the technology we have now where she can just instantly send out her messages and then just stay connected with her family and friends.
I know my uncle, great uncle Dave, talked about him being in the military. You got letters like only once every 1 or 2 months. So basically, it was like a time for him where he could reimburse with him and his family members. And it was like really hard impact for him. And that's why he thought letters were like such a big beating. Where today, where you can call and text anyone at any time, like nobody writes letters anymore. So, but he also likes the way that you can FaceTime like his grandkids or all his cousins and all of our family members. So our last question is, what were some differences you guys saw in your outlook on media versus the person you interviewed?
My father kind of mentioned that he thinks with the overall use of media being so much higher, especially social media, that it's kind of led to the public being overall less informed. I disagree with this somewhat because I feel like social media gives us a lot more access to opinions and ideas we don't have access to otherwise.
Yeah, so for me and Karen, kind of the biggest difference in our outlook on media was the reason we use it. For her, it was more of like to gain knowledge while also kind of keeping in touch with other people's lives. Versus me, I kind of use it more for entertainment and to communicate with friends and family.
For me and my aunt, the main difference between us was our general attitude towards media, as she believes it was like a place where she can like connect with people and just be informed about the world overall. While I believe it's more of a dangerous place where you can just meet up strangers and also like lose your information. So again, I view it as a dangerous place.
Agreed, agreed. Well, that's all the time we have today, folks, on the media. I thank you guys for joining us. Have a good night.